Furiosa and Mad Max Saga came out this year in 2024. This follows a young Furiosa going through her first adventures in the wasteland, from being kidnapped by a man named Dementus, played by Chris Hemsworth. And just a good movie. It's a prequel to Mad Max Fury Road. And it does have a lot of the same things that Fury Road does, but since it's almost 10 years old by this point, it also does have a lot of things that are relatively different. For instance, you still have a lot of the same action sequences that you would see in Fury Road, but they are enhanced, changed, and some would say not as good because of the CGI. Like, for example, the CGI does play a big part of this movie, and an example of this is, there's this character who, when they're making runs in this, like, big truck with, like, supplies and stuff in it, and they're being attacked, ambushed, there's this small little character who is just completely CGI. It's just, like, yapping, like, the whole time, and you'll just randomly see his head or something. This is for comic relief, which is not needed in the sequence. They just put it in because they had the budget, they had the CGI that they could use it, and while the CGI does help in a lot of sequences, in some sequences, it's not, and it's just unnecessary. Stuff that they could do for real, stuff that they didn't even have to include. And we also do spend a good chunk of the movie with a younger Furiosa going through her adventures. And now, this is probably the first 45 minutes of the film, but it's a 2.5-hour movie, so when you really think about it, that's a relatively small portion of the film. But yeah, we do follow a younger Furiosa, and we see her being kidnapped by a guy named Dementus. Which, being honest, Chris Hemsworth plays a great villain. I mean, he is such an idiot. Dementus is such an idiot. And just the way he goes out at the very end of the movie is just comical. And all around, a pretty good movie. Would I say it's as good as the first one? No, for a few reasons. It's just a different movie. And I didn't really care for the stuff with a younger Furiosa. And I know that sounds incredibly stupid, but when I say this, I mean that from where she gets kidnapped to when she leaves to be with Immortan Joe, from that period of time takes up such a large chunk of the movie. For some people, you just can't help but get tired of it after a certain point in the movie, which is probably something I did. And that's from the very beginning to around that point in the movie where it gets handed over to Dementus Joe. And after that, it just gets crazy. Like, that's where we get all the cool sequences with all the factions and everything. For at one point, Dementus takes over this certain part of the wastelands, like this base. And it's up to Furiosa and her inner mate or whatever to go in and basically just destroy the space. And it's just this contained sequence inside these gates, but it is still awesome. Stuff explodes, buildings fall over. Just a really good action sequence, which is something that these movies do really well. And they pride themselves on the car sequences, which is obviously why people go to see them for the most part. And it does it very, very well 9 years later, etc. Pretty good movie. Going to the good, the okay, and the bad, Furiosa is a good main character to follow after a certain point. Still, she is pretty interesting. Like, for instance, at one point she pretends to be mute, to get to a certain position so she can take down Dementus, which is just cool seeing her rise through the ranks. A good main character. Chris Hemsworth needs to play more villains, man. Yeah, Chris Hemsworth plays an amazing villain. Like, he's just such an... His character, he can just play these idiotic villains that are also so cunning and cruel. And this is a really good performance from Chris Hemsworth. Probably the best performance in this entire movie by my standards. Anyways, moving on from the action sequences, obviously, all those things, pretty good. Moving on with the okay. Again, like I said earlier, from after Furiosa gets taken to the point where she's handed over to Immortan Joe, that whole section could have been cut down so much. And that runtime that they could have cut down could have been given to more things like the car sequences, the secrets of a literal war that goes by in like a 2 minute montage, which is honestly just sad because I would have loved to see more of that. And since they're probably not going to do another prequel, we're probably never going to see that again. It still is a cool sequence I wish they would have expanded more upon, but they just didn't. Again, and moving on to the bad, nothing really is bad except for some things could have been cut down and given to other things that were way more important. Or something stuff that isn't important is so far drawn out that I feel like it could either mean that it shows how drawn out this moment was in Furious's life, or just they could have done that in an entertaining way, yet they do not. Maybe I'm just too stupid to realize this, and maybe in a couple days I'll be like, huh, that was pretty good. But I don't know, guys. Out of 100, I'm gonna give this movie a 83, since basically every action sequence just saves this movie. And I'm not gonna spoil what happens to Dementis at the very end, but it's just great. I mean, I'm not even gonna spoil it, but yeah, guys, if you enjoyed this video or any of my other content, please do subscribe. I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.